Well, in the first epistle of Peter, we read the words, "Think it not strange if you go through some fiery trials." The exact wording of that is, "Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial, which is to try you as though some strange things happened unto you." Living Bible says, dear friends, don't be bewildered or surprised when you go through the fiery trials ahead. For this is no strange, unusual thing that is going to happen to you. This is Pastor Hayton and the Lord Light's devotional. And as I was reading that today, I think of some of the trials that some of the best people on earth have gone through. You know, a lot of times we say, I just don't understand why that has happened to them. And a lot of times it's, why me, Lord? Why is all of this happening to me? What have I done to deserve something like this fiery trial? Those fiery trials may be times of real testing or temptation. Those fiery trials may be times of affliction or adversity. Times when the storms of life are really blowing upon us and we think, why am I going through this? Oftentimes we're tempted to ask, what did I do to deserve this kind of treatment? Well, Bible says, don't be surprised. Don't act surprised. Don't be surprised when you go through these fiery trials. God has a plan and God has a purpose for each one of us. And we know that the apostle went on to explain that when we go through the hard times of life, then we become a partner in Christ's suffering. And if you think you're suffering a lot, think of the life of Jesus Christ. You know, he was portrayed as a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And even though there were highlights in his life here on earth, but I'm sure that he was rejoicing and basking in the glory of men, yet by and large, he indeed was a man of sorrow, a man that knew what it was to really be acquainted with grief. And when I think about the life of Christ and his ultimate suffering, those final days of his life when he experienced the rejection of men, remember as he sat and looked out over Jerusalem, very ones that he had come to save, they rejected him. And he cried out, "Oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, why have you turned your back upon me?" And I think that surely we know that he must have felt much sorrow. And as the angry mob was crying out, "Crucify him, crucify him, release unto us Barabbas," a known violent criminal, you know that Christ must have suffered. And then, of course, the beating that he endured, agony that he suffered there on the cross, just because he loved us so much. And so, you know, we go through the fiery trials. We're not going to experience anything near what Christ went through, but we become a partaker in his suffering. We become, a partner in his suffering. And if we are a partner in his suffering and remain true and faithful throughout that time of a fiery trial, then we're going to rejoice in his glory. And so if we're going to share in his glory, then we have to be patient. We have to be willing to share in his suffering. So I think today that no matter what we're going through, let's realize that there's a better day ahead. And if we remain true and keep our trust and faith in God, then one of these days we're going to have a joy that is beyond compare any joy that we can experience here on earth. So I don't know what some of you may be going through today, but don't think it's strange. It's something God permits. We become a partner in his suffering that we might share in his glory. Heavenly Father, help us to endure all things. The Bible admonishes us to endure all affliction, all trials, all times of testing. Blessed is the man that endureth, for when he is tried, he shall come forth as gold. And so we want to be faithful during those times that life isn't treating us well. And we know that someday we'll become a partner in your glory And we pray that you'll just give us the grace that we need to be true and faithful in Christ's name. Amen. Well, I plan to see you tomorrow, Lord willing, here on the Lord Lights Devotional with Pastor Hayton. Goodbye now.